Can everybody
hear?
Uh-oh, can everybody hear me?
I can hear you guys
a little bit.
I can't hear myself.
I can hear myself for the first time.
I can hear me. Hey. Hey.
Red, put the other side of the headphones on me. Said y'all paid y'all bills, so I can put the other side of your headphones on this week.
Feel kind of a little warm in here too.
Oh no, no, actually, it's not quite as warm. Not yet.
No, it is.
Is it?
Oh, yes.
All right, I don't know. Maybe because I just
when I start glistening over my right eyebrow.
That's when that thing. You know, that's when you know it's special.
A little bit.
A little special. What's up, y'all?
What's going on?
Well, we let these people know what they tuned into.
This is the Unrestricted Radio Show, because Wednesdays are
unrestricted.
There you go.
About time Mo showed up.
Well, hold up. She's standing up, though. Because a lot of people used to think Mo was a midget at first. They was like, who the little big, you know, bickety midget up there? I'm like, go ahead. Don't be talking about her breath like that. She ain't a midget. She real size. Yeah, no, nah, because, you know, she looked like a little midget at the table.
I figured I would stand up. You know.
You got your shoes on.
No, I actually have my shoes on today.
Oh, okay. She got a little boots on. I see your little boots. You know what I'm saying? You try to make it winter and everything.
Cool.
I mean, the weather is kind of transitional right now.
Like, you don't know what to put on.
It's going to be like 68 in the daytime and like 35 in the morning.
Yeah, pretty much.
Mm-hmm. So, yeah, the boots work.
Thank you so much.
You got your little joint. You look like you ironed a little bit.
Nah, it wasn't as crisp as last week.
Nah, last week was a little bit more
crisp. Last week was like...
Last week was something different.
This is a pre-iron. He ironed that, put on
my seatbelt on.
Yeah. That's why I last time he was like, ah, that young is going to be, I ain't going to put the seatbelt on.
What you got on your feet?
I ain't got a little cute for nobody today.
Man, he ain't got the new buck on.
We ain't got no special guest.
Yeah, he ain't got the
Jay, new... Jay, I mean, you...
You and Sonny.
He got the new buck on. He ain't got the bucks on.
It's casual Wednesday.
Oh, it is?
Casual.
It's coming you all Wednesday.
Yeah, coming you all Wednesday.
That's every Wednesday for me. It's like iron, wrinkled.
Oh, but we got, okay, we got the little black t-shirt thing going, but you tried to button down. That's cool.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah, that is somebody fault.
Over the way.
That's Flash, girl. Ain't no jumping around. That's my man Flash right there. That's
right.
He ready to make his announcement at any moment. He is switching teams.
He's say, what color y'all wearing?
Good. I'm going to make sure my black is shiny.
Right. Even Sunny got her black and white on.
Yes. You know, we all on the same wavelength.
Oh, because
we ain't even say nothing to each other.
And we didn't. Got
black and white, you know what I'm saying? He got
something. She got her blue on.
And she got her blue.
I mean, that's, you know, I try to represent for both sides.
Oh, yeah.
You know?
You are a 50-50.
Treat your selfie.
You are a 50-50.
Treat your selfie. I like that shirt.
And then, you know, the denim to go with my man right there.
Whose shirt is that?
This is my shirt.
Oh, that's your brand?
You know she probably got a brand now. She like, oh look.
Do I need
I'm asking you, do you?
I'm just saying, do I need them? Do I need them?
Do you need your blocker?
You don't need them.
I'm just saying.
I'm asking
that's
you.
That's your brain.
I mean, you might want to put it out there to the people.
I'm not putting nothing out there just yet.
Just yet. Y'all hear that? It's exclusive on Unrestricted Radio Show.
Is it?
So just to let y'all know, everybody on the show got a shirt brand except for me.
And me.
Your Kanye blend.
I got the Kanye blend. Yeah. I'm going to come out. I'm going to see if I can get with... Eddie Van for Madness. We're going to do a Times Kanye blend. So it's going to be Madness shirts with holes in them. We're going to see how that rock, you know.
Young, it is hot in here though, a little bit.
We'll take some off.
You ain't got your little water today?
I don't. I mean,
look.
Clearly, you came in here with one bottle.
Hey, all I need was one bottle.
Producer got Red Bull.
Go ahead, get a Flash. Show him that move, Flash.
I'm just saying. You ain't got no core today?
Nah,
you came in here with one rag too.
It was last week was pay week, so I splurged on good water. So I went and tried.
You just spent $3.49 on water last week.
$3.49.
And now this week he just trapped.
I'm looking for a cup and a little joint out there in the restaurant. I'm like, hey, they got ice in the little joint out there. I'm trying to get down on some of that good everlasting life tap water.
Ew.
Woo. So a lot of people lot of stuff transpired. You know,
hold on, before that, why don't we let the people know who we are?
Oh, shoot.
We always be joning on each other. You know, they just assuming it's our regular family.
Right.
But so it's not.
Who's this young lovely lady here that's standing up today that's not a midget in real life?
Well, oh, wow.
You see how he brought that down for you?
I did. Well, I would be Miss Moby. Mobo, you know.
Okay. And what do you do?
I'm like one third of the Unrestricted Radio show.
Oh, that's right.
All right. We like that. We like that.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Get it, baby. You like it.
That's You're it, so stupid. I did. I was like, should I be hyped about it? Like, yeah, I'm one third of the Unrestricted Radio show.
Now, you slid into your little.
I did.
Your little boyfriend late night voice. You're like, I'm not asleep yet, boo. I'm just laying here. Nah. The door unlocked.
He got a key.
Move, Diggy. I'm on the phone. Move, Diggy.
Stop, Diggy. Stop licking my toes.
I'm on the phone. Stop.
So she says she's Moby and she's the first lady and she's a.
What's your sign?
I'm a Virgo.
And she's a Virgo.
Oh, gosh. And she likes Merlot.
I'm smoky.
You just smoky.
I'm just smoky. You know, you might catch me somewhere, or you might not catch me there, but you'll definitely catch me here. Unrestricted Radio on Wednesdays. So, and who are you, brother?
I am Mr. Black Militant.
AKA
Dan Rutherby with your girl.
Hey, okay. AKA.
Who the hell is he?
AKA Mama, who's that man? Give it up for my main man,
Dwayne Davis.
You remember how you used to play basketball? He's like,
man of DMV, love to hate.
Don't they? I don't know why.
They love to hate you.
I'm like, God.
Man, they hate you when you're on the top, baby. You know?
That's what they say.
I'm on the top with the best, though.
Well, you know.
You on top of the best or you on top with the best?
Both.
Okay. See, sometimes you just got to put it out there.
You got to clarify for the people that hate you.
Because some people might think he just go for anything.
Pretty much.
No.
You know, I seen you on your phone and you had them long nails and I thought you just go for anything because you was a pimp and you be just scooping girls up. Now, I seen somebody say that to him before. Yeah. I was like, who the hell are you talking
you
about?
You be scooping girls? You be scooping them up?
I saw you, using your nails to scoop up coke and get a girl.
I was like, who are you talking about? Ike Turner? I don't know this person.
That's funny.
So did you do anything over the weekend? Like, would you take a picture down the harbor this week? Did you go to a party that you didn't invite us to? Let us know. I know you did something.
I didn't go to any parties. I didn't take any pictures at the harbor.
Nope.
And I always try to prepare myself because I know you're going to ask me, but I try to remember what I did and I don't remember. Oh! Bam! Shout out. Turn your headphones down. Shout out to my girl Victoria Davis, Vic Jagger of the Russ Paul Morning Show. I hung out with her on Saturday at Stonefish. She is the new midday personality for 102.3 starting on November the 26th. Shout out, give her a hand.
And we had her here first. You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
On our big show.
On our big show.
Yes.
Congratulations to her little show.
Yeah, we love you, girl.
We love you, Vic Jagger. Do it, girl. Still on Russ Paul from 5:30 to 10, and then she has her own show from 10 to 3.
And if you're looking for a side man on the show, just like
Yeah, we hung out with her at Stonefish, her and Rico.
Oh, okay. How was that? We had fun.
Yeah, it was. And then DJ Gemini, came on after midnight. So that was was real, real cool.
So we know if we want to get Mo to come out to a club, we got to tell her Vic going to be there.
Exactly. I was going to say something, but I'm going to let it go.
Because you ain't going to come out for us. So we got to make sure if we wanted to come out.
Oh, my gosh.
We got to say Vic Jagger going to be there. So Vic Jagger, we might lie on you a couple times. Don't worry about it.
Then I get there and be like, this joint bootleg janky.
Like, hold up.
Like, Tiff, girl, where you at?
They said you was up here.
I'm coming where you at.
I didn't really do too much. I chilled out this weekend.
You didn't do your
Community service? Oh,
no,
that's next week.
No, no. Nah, your joint you be doing on Friday.
Oh, no, no. They took a break last Friday. They coming back this Friday. Okay. But this Friday, they got a band.
They got a band,
yeah, you know.
Uh-oh.
Look, the promoter's doing what they want to do.
R-E.
The Re-Up Band. It's a brand new band
called
the Re-Up Band.
You should have cited the R-E.
You're like,
R-E. No. Hold up. That's not what it is.
I help y'all. I wouldn't tell nobody short because they might give me. I mean, I haven't heard the band yet. I know some of the members. Shout out to my man Trey Dog. He always got a cranking band when he's in a band, but I haven't heard it. So I can't say R E because you might be thinking R E E S S E N C E. You know what I'm saying? Real S's, but that's not the band. And they're not going to be locking it in there. They're not, you know what I'm saying?
That was wordplay, brother. You should have went with it.
I don't want to sell people a dream because they can buy. They're not supposed to buy dreams. You know?
That's true.
So I'm not gonna sell them none. Some of them already bought some dreams already, but I'm not here to give them anymore. It's the Re-Up Band. Okay. They're gonna be up there. DJ Knock is gonna be on one of the two, and I'm gonna be hosting. So it's definitely gonna be a party. Come through, you know, Crystal Lounge up in Langley Park.
$10 for the ladies, $20 for the fellas.
I believe, I don't know the it exact is. Price.
I made the flyer.
Oh, so you're promoting.
Yes, so he's around his DMV.
It's around my DMV.
He knows.
Now I can take this out of my lineup.
That's the best part. He actually read it. My picture's on the flyer, and I don't know what it says, but he read it.
So. He posted it.
Wow.
I'm sorry. I mean.
You did?
Yeah, I just did today. I'm high.
Oh, okay.
But, you know, when you're high.
He's stepping his game up on this promotion.
He's okay, then.
You know, we're going to get into that later. You know what I'm saying? So, you didn't do anything, did you?
I didn't do anything.
Except?
But survive the weekend.
Man, that's something.
Give me a moment.
Put your fist up. You might as well put your fist
Come
up,
on,
too.
Mo.
This I like when you in church and everybody put their hand up and then they be like, raise your hand. You be like.
You just want to be cute. But I do want to say that my daughter's birthday. She turned sweet 16 on Saturday.
Dang, you got a 16-year-old?
You old, yo.
Girl? I got a 20-year-old.
Girl? Not a girl.
Nah, 16-year-old girl, 20-year-old boy.
You the 16-year-old girl. That's scary.
Oh, trust me. I already know.
I'm not scared. You let me know if you need me to come over there and be like.
If I'm missing one Wednesday, y'all know where I'm at. Up the street.
And we got to be like
bad. Up my bro.
Like bad boys. Be like, hey, this her uncle just came home. Like, I mean, that joke. You look like you're about 30.
Right.
So
roughing the little boys up.
She's still a little girl. 16 little girl, so.
That's cool.
That's good. That's good. So. There's an air in the room, isn't there?
Yeah.
The air's thick. It's all around the DMV.
The air is thick.
It's the air on the bus. You know, people on the bus. You know what? I saw the bus driving down the street, the A6, with no black people in the back. All the black people were sitting in the front. So people feeling some kind of way. And you know the A6 be crazy. You know, they be smoking jacks, rolling loud in the back of that joint, everything.
I wouldn't know. I don't ride the bus. I'm sorry.
So, see.
I'm just saying.
Okay, so let me put it in different terms. The bus is like Uber, except a lot of people can get on.
I don't know. Uber share.
Yeah, it's like a big Uber share without the aux cords. So you can't.
Have you ever rode the Metro bus?
Yes.
Okay.
I'm about to say, if no Metro.
Now,
no.
Mind you, I was probably 16 or 15, but.
Oh, yeah. You riding them over them little boys' houses.
Look at it.
Leave them Riverdale Baptist.
And look, she was like, look, girl, look. Look, put
girl,
your
what's a token?
She was like, girl, put your tennis skirt in my book bag so your mother don't see.
Indeed, you already know. You already know.
That's how y'all was rolling. But it's a different.
Yeah, when they had the little transfers, the little paper joint.
Oh, you could. You really remember the
game. Yeah, I mean, it was back in the day.
Okay. That's
all right. Shut up. This is going to be brought up again. I already know.
Who's on the transfer? Which man was on the transfer?
Did you have a blue joint or red joint?
The red one was that
I don't know. They were just gray.
Gray. That was the old joint.
Yeah, exactly.
All right.
This is going to come up again.
We're going to revisit this. But there's definitely, you know, but see, this is good. We can laugh and be lighthearted because a lot of people don't feel the same way.
It's cool.
You know why? Because of this election.
Yeah.
A lot of people were expecting something totally.
Where the election?
They really were.
You know, you did.
Where the election?
Can you vote?
This one.
Unfortunately, I can't.
Brother Bagway, did they take your rights?
This battle blows my life. Do you hear me?
I can't, though.
You can't?
I'm a convicted felon.
There are steps you have to take, but you just, it's like, it is steps. Like, you got to go through a process.
But you know what? I was actually reading some of your comments and your statuses on Facebook, and I didn't like them.
How did you feel?
You're being very pessimistic about this entire election process.
He is being dang rather now.
It was blowing me a little bit, like, but I know
so,
you.
So I didn't speak truth on my post?
No, it was your truth.
No, it's the truth.
No, it was your truth. This cool.
I'm going to vote for you.
I don't need you to vote for me.
Vote for president. I should have wrote Mo in. She might have, you know what I'm saying? Mo might have got some votes.
I'm just
people
saying,
do
because it trips me. And not just you, but the things that people were saying last night leading into today, your friends list changed, and people were saying that like this week and last week, and I was like, nah, it's not so, like, you know.
So what was wrong with what was on my post?
We'll get into that, but go ahead.
Or did she just point back to you?
She kind of took your conversation and held it in her hand, right. Put it down for later. She's like, we'll get into that. I'm gonna hold your door right here. Back to you.
No, she's like, Diggy, don't fetch that Diggy.
No.
Because no, I'm gonna tell you no. Because I don't want to hold my peace. So basically, you didn't think that a woman would be, that we're not ready for a woman. I'm asking you.
Okay.
Do you think that we're not ready for a woman president?
I'm not saying that I don't think that we are ready. I don't think they are ready.
Mm-hmm. Well, they weren't ready for a black one.
And they gave us that.
They gave it to us?
They gave us that.
No, we took that.
How many years was it? Okay, I don't. I don't normally talk politics.
I'm about to vote right now for you. I'm
just saying.
You want to hold this one for a little bit?
Yeah, I will.
We'll hold this one. You want to talk about some random hot topics? Because that's
Let's talk about some random hot topics. Because, for real, I'm getting hot.
It's getting hot here?
It's getting hot.
Well, take off all your clothes. Here we go. That's what Nelly would tell you to do. You know, this is Unrestricted Radio Show Hot Topics, where we normally kind of spill the tea, but we don't like to spill the tea. We like to knock over the whole picture mm-hmm. and get your whole ish wet.
Yeah.
So here we go. In news this week, rapper Rick Ross, the boss, he's going through some tax troubles. Right now, he can't even get the wing stuff up and ready. It's like, nah. He's going through some tax troubles right now, and he owes the IRS something to the tune of $5.7 million.
Younger.
From 2012 to 2014, they said the breakdown claims that Ross owes more than $4.6 million in 2012 alone, and then another $570,000. You need to bail for this one out. $570,000.
Okay.
For 2013 and 14.
Okay.
They're about to put a tax lien on his ass.
They should have been did that.
So he might not be able to rock his Bentley. He might not be able to rock some of them other fancy cars he got.
He'll be all right.
If he don't pay that bread.
He'll be all right.
Rick Ross, pay your bread. In other news, there is a young lady going around, and she has a new profession. And I was going to ask you, could you see yourself doing this?
I couldn't see myself doing this, but I know about her profession.
Oh, so you know that there's a young Brooklyn resident by the name of Amaku Apong, and she's a professional cuddler.
Mm-hmm.
Professional,
and she makes a lot of money doing this.
Actually, she does it for $80 an hour. So she's cuddling with people. She's not giving out any sexual type experience.
So she says
because we don't know what happens behind those closed doors if you put out an extra $100. I'm just saying.
Exactly.
Like, you know what I'm saying? She might get down, but she might not.
Is that with panties or without panties?
I think the cuddling is with clothes for the
$80. It's with clothes on.
$80.
Yeah, she's like sometimes I'll be like, you need a hug.
Well,
your attitude.
well, the cuddlers.
But people actually pay for it.
They pay for it. I'm trying to figure out how I can get down. Like, I would cuddle.
Would you pay $80 to cuddle with somebody?
Lynette.
Yeah, I wouldn't pay $80 to cuddle with nobody. I mean, except Oprah. Now I would pay $80 to cuddle with Oprah for an hour. Just for the simple fact that I would try to get my dry rub on as hard as I could to maybe she feels something, and then she feels some kind of way. And then maybe I could, bam, I didn't hit the jackpot.
But she's not doing it sexually.
I mean, if I don't know how to cuddle.
Okay,
sexually.
I'm going to ask, what race is she?
She's black. She's a sister. And she said she actually gets a lot of white men clientele that say they have never touched black skin before. And they want to know what it feels like to touch brown skin.
And she has other people working with her, other colors.
Yeah, she has a white dude, too, that does it, too. But he colors with women.
I hope so.
Wait a minute. I'm not 100% sure if he only colors with women, because he might go, you know, he might be like, well, okay, you know. So
I personally couldn't do it. I just believe in transference of energies.
Even from cuddling?
Yes.
So, like, if you wouldn't even hug a negative person.
Cuddling is intimate.
So, do you hug people when you meet them?
Not everybody. I mean, I am a hugger. If I feel the vibe, if I'm not, it's like a pound or a shake. I shake your hand.
If I'm like,
I'm like,
does that wash the movie when he touches you?
Yeah, exactly. Time.
Get the joint in. So
yes, it is.
So if anybody,
that's true. That happened.
Falling. That's what it was.
Yeah. If anybody feels some kind of way, they feel like they need a color, there's a person out there you can contact. This young lady, I'm sure if you Google her, you can find her online.
Yes. And she's in New York. And she's right in New York City.
And for the right price, I'm sure she'll jump on that train and come down and cuddle you. But if you have $150 and you want to cuddle, call Unrestricted Radio at 240-455-5934. If you have a credit card and you're going to pay someone's car payment, me and Dwayne may cuddle you if you're a female. I'm just saying.
We do payment plans.
We do cash day, payday cash loans and title lien loans. So let us know. And in the last bit of news, we have... You remember last week when Lil Wayne went on the news and he was talking all crazy about he don't understand racism and, you know, he don't understand, he don't relate to Black Lives Matter? Well, T.I. checked him.
I saw that.
And he checked him publicly on Instagram. T.I. went into a lengthy post on Instagram about, you know, this is my son and daughter showing me this for the first time, asking me what you mean. I'm at complete loss for words here, Wayne. I've known you for decades and our daughters grew up together. I mean, practically Reginae spent countless times at our house with Neek, and you were in prison. And you did the same for me when I was in prison. So, you know, I'm very sensitive to the disposition that you are taking while you are out here on TV. He goes on to say, bro, I know you're weird and you're not wired like other adults, but come on, man. Mm-hmm. You're making yourself look like a coon. Well, Reginae...
But I didn't think that he really... That wasn't like a come for him.
No, he did. He really
he
did
was like,
come for
him. He really he said it like how he...
No, he didn't come for him. He checked.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, but in everything he said, I'm your homie. You know, you got to do better. I will help you. Mm-hmm. He didn't, you know, he did everything you're supposed to do. Now, granted, some people say he should have did it off of Instagram.
Exactly. I was going to say that, but...
I kind of feel like that, too, because I feel like if Dwayne is going to check me, like... Don't check me right on my page. You're like, damn, right. Bro. Like,
you got my number. You know where I stay at. You
but who's to say that he didn't
do
that?
You inbox me if you want to go to Roses. I mean,
who's to say that he didn't do that? I mean, after.
But even if he did, but why make it public? That's your friend. That's supposed to be your home. You
yeah.
Want to like to
and
your
you embarrass your friends sometimes.
No, you
they
don't.
Need that.
No.
That's what I think.
Like that. I mean, come on now. Like, I just felt some kind of way about doing it on the page. I feel like if you got a spat with somebody and it's your real homie, you call them. Or you just do it, you know, it's private, you know, like.
But I don't think it was a spat.
It's not really a spat, but it was just kind of an issue.
Okay.
Like I don't like your jacket.
Well, you did that on the radio, so.
I'm embarrassed, my friend.
Right, you know what I'm saying? Like, okay. He said.
Well, maybe I needed to be embarrassed.
I don't.
I'm just like, I don't care. Okay.
Exactly. You just say like, so you're
so
that's fine.
Who the hell are you? You ain't know why. Like, it's like, nah.
Whatever.
That was all we got for Hot Topics.
Okay.
You know,
right?
Today's sponsor.
Oh, I'm scared.
Fat Smokey's Travel Agency, y'all.
Oh. Where are we traveling to?
Well, this is for the people who are unhappy with the current situation with our president. Mm-hmm. If you want to move out of the country, call me. I have specials to get you started.
Hmm.
I have specials going to Quebec Terrace. If you want to go to Quebec, call me. I'll get you set up, and you'll get straight to Quebec Terrace. If you want to go to Jamaica, we'll send you straight to Jamaica, Queens. If you want to get there, you don't need a passport, you call my travel agency, and we will get you straight on a flight to Jamaica, Queens.
That's that.
So, you know, you have other options. You don't have to stay here. You can go to Quebec Terrace, and you can also go to Jamaica, Queens, for Fat Smokey's Travel Agency.
That's what's up. That's what
I, so call us, you know.
Prices are low, too, huh?
So before we take this music
I
break,
take loud.
I hope y'all ready.
Okay.
For what?
What are we?
Unrestricted
what should we
and
oh, I want some.
Restricted.
Oh, yeah, I'm ready. But I'm ready for that.
All right.
I am too. We need these straight off the cuff.
We need more followers to call in 240-455-5934. The number's 240-455-5934.
If you ever went to school with Mo or you rode the bus with her with the transfers, let us know, you know. We'll let you know if y'all was riding the bus down to Triples or somewhere back in the day or the Panorama Room. Oh, Wilbur's Park.
Now we had to ride down. Let us know. The bus ain't go to Wilbur's Park.
Let us know. We'll be right back. Unrestricted Radio, because Wednesdays are
Unrestricted.
Yeah.
This ain't on the list, neither. I just want y'all to follow me, okay? got at least 10 haters. Slipping on your pimping. Don't get mad though, cause you need that. I don't know if they wanna fight me or screw me, slap me, you do me. I must be lying. Don't blame me, I get it from my mama. Go on, little girl, you don't want the drama. I told you once, I'm telling you twice. I need the owl, baby, be right here. Make it nice.
Yeah, we back, we black. You know what? So, like I said earlier, Wednesdays are
unrestricted.
That's right.
Oh, you came back over to, you was like,
yeah, he leaned in that joint. He tried to get official with it. So, but I liked it. I liked that energy.
Yeah, that was kind of cool.
So, we back. You know the number to call. If you want to call in the station, it's 240-455-5934.
What's that number?
240-455-5934.
All right.
And, we were talking a little bit about the election. Yeah, what? Yeah, exactly. What you won't do
is eat on Sunny's show.
Right. She checked you real fast. Like.
She did.
Thank you, Sunny, because I didn't even know what to tell the boy. He was chomping and everything.
Boy is a racist word.
Whoa.
Trump look, follower.
Is that what we're doing now? Like, every time, like, man, come on, boy. Like, I'm a boy now. Trump follower. Like.
Gotta get it.
So
stick grabber.
Were you up when they announced it?
Yes. Me, I ain't gonna lie. I tried. I was looking. I was going back and forth between other shows because it was like, I was like, why my stomach feel like this? Like, you know, it's like that stomach, like when you're going over a hill in the car and it go real fast and you on a roller coaster.
You had a knot joint.
Yeah, I had a little knot in my stomach. Mm-hmm. I ain't understand. I was like, I don't understand. Like, so I just left it alone, and I cut the TV off. And I said, I'll just worry about it in the morning. I'm not really worried about it, but find out.
Right. I wanted to know, period.
So you stayed
but
up.
But I went to a watch party.
Oh, that had to be heartbreaking.
It figures.
You know why? Because neither one of us got invited.
I went to a watch party. The watch party was actually really, really cool. It was down at the harbor.
Down the harbor. It was, was it at the new joint, the MGM?
No, it was at Pose Nightclub on the 18th floor of the Gaylord.
Lord have mercy. Look, you see how she lightly stunned on me? She was like, it was at Pose Nightclub, you know, at the...
On the 18th floor of the Gaylord. But it was cool because everybody in there was Democrats. So the energy was real high. So everybody was enthusiastic and they were hopeful. And they had, you know, like the big screens up and everybody was watching the numbers and stuff like that. But at that time, it was close. So we were still really hopeful.
Yes.
But then I came home and I still had the TV on. I made it to like 12:30. And then I was like, I'm sleepy. But I turned the TV up so that if I heard any kind of extra cheering, that it would wake me up. And that's exactly what happened. And it was across the screen. And it said Clinton calls Trump and concedes the election. I'm like, oh, no. Diggy was upset. Like, that man woke up like, no, what happened?
Like, oh shit! Oh. So, I mean, I ain't gonna lie, I couldn't believe it.
I was blown though. I had to just like lay there, and I'm looking at the TV like, for real though.
I was like, is this like even real life? Because it don't feel like real life.
Nah.
How did you feel? I know you ain't stay up.
This sure man was watching Love & Hip Hop Hollywood or something like that.
I wasn't worried about it because I kind of knew the outcome already.
Of course you did, Mr. Pessimist.
Hey, it is what it is.
Did it turn out true? You're going to say that because...
I said that earlier, though.
Did you feel that way about Obama?
No.
So you were just like, oh.
I felt like he had a chance because Obama was clean. They couldn't dig nothing up on him.
Well, you know, I kind of like knew Obama was going to win when he got up there and they was like, well, the best we can do is he's not born in America. I was like, that's all y'all got? Like, exactly. You couldn't find a baby mama? Like, somebody had an abortion and he ain't give him all the money or something? I mean, I knew something. Obama, he was squeaky clean. Like, yeah. I don't even know a black person that clean. I wish I did. Mama?
So what's your issues with Trump, Mo?
My issues with Trump is that I feel that he is a racist. I feel that he is. And people will say, oh, he's not a racist. He employs black people. Yeah, so does companies out here that they're blatantly racist, but they're black people working for them. Yeah. They need the job done. So they're going to hire Latinos or black people or Mexicans or, I mean, Chinese people, whatever. I do think that he's a racist. And he doesn't have any experience at all.
Neither did Ronald Reagan.
No, Ronald Reagan was a senator before he got.
You can't.
He could have been. He was a movie star first, but then he did.
Exactly. Yeah, but like, no, like, what do you know Donald Trump for? Seriously, like, if somebody was business. To say exact, but outside of that.
But you asked me, business in America is a business.
Right. That's but true. If somebody's voting for the first time, if somebody is 18, 19, they're just voting for the first time, they know Donald Trump from The Apprentice. So.
I don't.
Well, I'm telling you.
You ain't 18 or 19, old man.
I'm 20. Okay, but even still, he's a businessman. America is business.
But is it okay for the president to have casinos?
Yes.
I think, yes.
That was because, I think it's okay that he had businesses before he came president.
So if we're going to war, your business acumen is going to lead your...
Well, I'm pretty sure he has people in place for that.
Yes, they're his advisors. But because you have no experience doing this type of thing, your business acumen is going to be the leading thing, like the cause for your... You know, final decisions and things of that nature.
Yes, I agree.
I don't.
Because if before I blow China up, I'm going to think how many Apple phones come from over there. All the money coming to America. I mean,
he's like, look.
You're thinking like a DMV savage.
We might need to drop the bomb on China, but
pal,
the iPhone 8 comes out next month.
Is that?
I mean,
and they haven't shipped yet.
No.
Do you think he makes out?
I don't think he's a racist.
Do you think he makes us more vulnerable?
Yes and no.
I don't think he's going
to
play.
Trump brought to light the racism that we already knew was still alive and well, but that we may have been a little bit removed from it in 2016, so we might have felt like it that, oh, we don't experience it as much anymore. But he brought to light that your neighbor is racist too, or thinks like me, but you may not think that because you felt removed from it.
So let me ask you this question. Do you feel though everybody's bothered because he's being honest?
Well, no.
And he's a public figure?
I'm going to say, first of all, I don't think he's a racist. I think he's an opportunist. What he did was he used the portion of the Republican Party that the regular Republican Party needed their vote, but they didn't like to shed light on. And he catered to them. They're the bigots and the, you know, he said what they wanted to hear. He said he wanted them to hear, build a wall, ban the Muslims, you know.
He offended anybody you could think of.
But he didn't offend me. He did it to a certain crowd. He appealed to that crowd. Donald Trump has been a flip-flopper. If you watch all his videos,
everything.
He flip-flops on everything. And that's actually what a businessman would do. Not a politician.
Mm-hmm.
Flip-flop when you need to. Mm-hmm. If you need to be friendly with these people, that's who you be friendly with. If you need to talk crazy about these people to these people to make them think that you're more like them, that's what you do. That's what a conniving businessman would do.
Mm-hmm.
And that's exactly what he did. I think he'll sing a totally different tune in the White House. Now, I don't like him necessarily, but I think I respect his gangster of how he took it. He told people a long time ago, if I ever ran for president, I'd run as a Republican. Because Republicans are the dumbest party and they believe anything they see on Fox News.
Mm-hmm.
And that's exactly what he did. Like, you know, that's pretty gangster to me.
I don't think that, and my mother and I were talking about this, I don't think that he thought he was going to get this far.
I don't either.
He probably thought, like, once it was the RNC, like, oh my gosh, like, wow, I made it to Republican National Convention. And then I'll probably fall off. But, like, to get all the way to the end, like, you're like a mile before the finish line, and then it's like, I could actually win this.
I agree.
But you have to think, he has a hell of a team behind him, though. He give it to him. Now, if he can get this far, it's not Trump himself. It's his team.
Well, no, was him.
It was him.
Everyone else had to, let me see.
No,
everyone else
him.
Had to use their team. Trump used his celebrity to boost him. So it wasn't really his team.
How do you think he got? So you think he tweeted all that stuff himself?
Yeah. Yes.
That's why it came out. That's why it comes out so stupid.
Because these are
tweets.
If he's not doing it, he's dictating it to somebody. Trust me on this.
Nah, Trump puts out enough wrong statistics.
Huh?
Nothing. Nah, Trump tweets enough wrong statistics for him not to have. Like, you wouldn't pay somebody to tweet wrong statistics.
Everybody has this person on their friends list. The person who says profound things, the most profound things, and you like, what is this mama saying on Facebook? And everybody has a friend like that. I do. I'm not friends with them anymore, but.
Oh, my God, I'm on the way.
I'm not friends with this person anymore, but. This person used to say the most profound things, and I know him. And I'm like, dude, you don't even think like this. You're just saying this to rouse other people up. Yeah. And I felt like that's what Trump did and does. But the thing is, with him, he believes these things.
I don't
believe in your words.
No. I don't think he believes all that stuff. Like,
it's just like,
he just says it to get, you know, to get what he needs.
True. But I mean, what did he do? What did he achieve by doing that? There were people on your block, people that teach our kids, people that you may have sat next to at your job who think just like him and are there. He's riling them up and they're like, yes, we have a voice. I don't really have to be with Obama anymore.
To play the devil advocate, didn't us as a people do that for Barack Obama?
Yes, but he didn't.
Yeah.
He didn't.
Didn't we do what?
We rallied for Obama. We rallied like when he was a great hope.
Well, he was a great hope, but he was a great hope even if he wasn't black.
But yeah, now the thing about Obama is he had twice as many white people behind him as he had black people.
Exactly.
So I have to give it. It was no really race divide.
The
only divide was the bigot divide. Now, the people that were against Obama is exactly who Donald Trump catered to. Now, me personally, I don't feel comfortable having a 70-year-old person in the White House as the leader of such a progressive country.
Why because not a vice president? If something happened to him, we're good.
But he's scary, too. Like, he's a scary dude, too. But, you know, Trump is going to be starting messing with Rudy Giuliani and Newt Gingrich, other 70-year-old white men. Mm-hmm. Now, when he says, make America great again, when a 70-year-old white man says, I want to make America great again, the America he's talking about is not the progressive America that we all know as 30, 40, and 20-year-olds. Mm-hmm. It goes a little bit back further than that.
Do you think he's talking about you and your children?
How you know he's not just talking about bringing jobs back in general, making it great?
The rich stay richer. They protect themselves. They're not trying to protect you. I'm not saying you poor, but
I'm about to say, hold on now.
Direct that to me, because I'm poor. So.
I'm just saying, the rich stay richer. That's how it is. They're not trying to bring anybody else up to their level. They're trying to protect what they already have. This man that said on national TV, he has not paid taxes in 10 years. And there's other rich people that are like, I can do that too. I want to follow him.
It's poor people that do the same thing.
You be like,
but I'm just saying.
Lil Riri.
Mo is very passionate about this.
Yeah. Lil Riri, bring Man over here and his social security number so I can claim on my taxes.
This is.
Okay, on the flip side, great. Though. Just like
right.
You said, he's the rich get richer.
The rich get richer.
Shouldn't that motivate the poor?
Exactly.
I got a problem giving my money to a mom who takes her little check every month and don't do the right thing. So couldn't he stop that?
No.
Welfare benefits. Can he have something like that?
Sonny, I'm with you.
Welfare is not going anywhere, for one, because unfortunately people think that Shaniqua and her five kids are the face of welfare, and to the media it is. But since black people only make up 15% of the country as a whole, the majority of the people on welfare and, you know,
is Billy Ray and Susie Joe.
Is Amy Lynn and her four kids. They're in West Virginia.
Billy Ray?
They're in rural West Virginia. They're in rural Kentucky. They're in rural Tennessee. They're in rural Pennsylvania. And they need it just as bad as us. But it's far more of them that need it than us.
Yeah, true that.
So that's not going to go anywhere.
So the next 4 years, us as the people, us as voters, we just need to make a change. To get him out of office, correct?
You strap your boots up, yeah.
Are you going to look into this convicted felon needing to vote?
First of all, you got to know why I'm a convicted felon.
It doesn't matter why.
No, you do know why. Then I'll let you know why I can't vote.
Are you going to look into
voter fraud?
This? You are so whack, yo.
He's been killing this since 1992. He's been killing that thing, boy. Lord, but you know what? You know what I say?
What?
I say, don't let yourself get too up and anxious about it. We've gone through far, far worse things in life. Honestly, yep. I think we're going to be okay because, I mean, Trump has to live in America too, so he doesn't want to ruin it. I mean, there's some hope. There is.
He might get in office and do some good things.
And that also opens.
You never know.
That also opens the door for the next president, because the next president does not have to be a politician.
True.
They don't have to have previous experience. So Kanye West could be the president. Steve Harvey could be the president, and he could run as the Bass Party, the big ass suit party. Who else could be the president?
Mo.
Bernie Sanders around.
Mo.
I would never know.
Oh, yeah, Mo could be the president.
Never.
Diggy could be the first dog.
Diggy could be the first dog. And we already know. You did get a. I heard you did get a vote. Not for real. Because, you know, look, they said Harambe, the gorilla got 15,000 votes written in.
Yeah. Hey, yo.
Mo got one vote written in. I seen it online. For real. They said Lynette wrote your name in on the back. On the ballot in North Carolina. They said They counted all the ballots in North Carolina.
All hey, them. Yeah.
It was 100.
What was it for?
Yeah, they're like, who the hell is it? It's a Boss Lady Moan.
Devolution.
Devolution that did everything for me. It should be the president.
Oh, God.
I'm sorry, y'all.
You're stupid.
That's what I thought was going down. So
oh, my God.
I don't know. But we're going to go to a music break. We'll come right back, and it's the Unrestricted Radio Show.
Hey, get ready for the Unrestricted and Restricted Hour. Get ready to call in 240-455-5934. Make sure you call in as Mo, Smokey, and myself. Them restricted, please. But mostly them unrestricted questions.
Yes,
to Dwayne.
Get ready for
the answer. Dwayne. Yes, call Dwayne Davis at 240-455-5934.
Go. We'll be back.
I'm a bad motherfucker, goddamn it, these
great.
That's what you get. You never know when we're gonna get live up in here.
Well, you gotta be real live, real loud too.
Hey, you got her. You got her.
You got me on like 12.
You got her jamming on. You got her jamming on one. You gotta turn me down too a little bit.
Yes, turn me down.
It's only loud because Sunny wanted to jam in the studio, so I gotta turn the studio sound down.
Oh, okay, yeah. Okay.
I gotta do it how they be doing in the studio on Love & Hip Hop.
Yeah, do it how they do on Love & Hip Hop. How they doing on Love & Hip Hop?
Wait, they be like this. Hey, Ray J, run that back. Run that back. 16 balls right there.
They making no music. They bullshitting in the whole time.
Ray J said, we got a compilation coming out. It's hot, too.
You my man, Ray J, alone.
Can you turn me up? I really can't, like, hear myself.
Damn, turn you up, turn you down.
Parking all day, line is on. Pull up and don't pay me with that. Hey, we up in here. We up in here.
Shiggity wiggity.
We back. Unrestricted Radio, because Wednesdays are
unrestricted.
And we are now. What are we doing, Mo?
We finna do Wisdom Wednesday.
We're doing to do what?
Wisdom Wednesday.
Wisdom Wednesday. That's what we about to do, y'all. Give it up. Ready? Hold up. There you go. Drop that for us. You know when we do Wisdom Wednesday, we like to get down.
I'll be blowing with this.
We like to get up. We like to bring it down.
Hey, yeah, for real. You blow
for the sisters, you having problems with your man.
Do you feel like busting his tires?
Do you feel like breaking his windows?
I bust the windows out your car, Jasmine Sullivan.
Yeah.
Mo got something for you.
As always, each and every Wednesday.
I really do. You want to turn it down some more?
Oh, you want to turn it down?
Can you turn it down some more?
I feel I was trying to set the mood for the ladies.
It's okay.
Fellas,
Lauren Hill.
Fellas, if it's a candle lit, blow it out, because she might try to throw the wax on you after this.
It's not about the ladies tonight.
What was it, hot grits?
Or hot 20s? Grits. Do the Al Green. She might do the Al Green to you.
If she's on the EBT car, it's Farina.
You are such a bama. No, so actually, because like to end up on the election thing that we were talking about,
mm-hmm.
I felt that we were just culminated with this, so it's not about the ladies tonight. It's no men bashing.
What
about okay? Damn time.
Jesus.
It's no men bashing. It's not. It's just to culminate with everything that we've been talking about this evening. So everybody's feeling mad, upset. And everything and upset and all that good stuff, but God is still in control.
Mm-hmm.
We're human. So all of the emotions we feel right now are valid. But if you serve the same God that you pray to before the election, you know the word says that he's the same yesterday, today, and forever.
Mm.
We can't lean on our own understanding. This is bigger than us as a people and a country. So God is our GPS on this road that we travel on.
Well,
I never put my trust in man. And I always bet on God, the one who can shut all of this down.
Down.
With the blink of an eye. The beginning and the end, the alpha and the omega.
All right now.
That's it.
That was, hey, snap it up for that. Snap it for Mo.
You want to snap?
And her Wisdom Wednesdays.
But you got to snap and you got to like.
Oh, you got to give him the shoulders too?
Yeah,
hit him with the shoulders.
Yeah, why you a hater?
What are you talking about?
No.
I don't like when you do that.
You got to look, we got to be happy that that was not a man bashing moment. Because we were going to switch Wisdom Wednesdays to man bashing.
He was bashing Trump. He's a man. Come on, brother. You got to think.
You're right. You
got to think.
See, I wasn't with you,
she
Brother
tried
Bay
to
Wayne.
Trick us, man.
I was not with you, Brother Bay Wayne.
Bamboozle us.
I need to go back to my hut and read some more, brother.
Exactly.
That's right. What I need to do.
See, what they teach us.
It's the man that's keeping it so hot in here.
It's the man that's oppressing you with this heat, my sister.
Indeed. Good God.
See, if you was to pay your rent.
Yeah.
You would be able to solidify some air conditioning.
Indeed.
So
I would purify the air.
Would you?
So we here, and this is the top of the hour. Mm. And you know what that means.
I'm scared.
What you scared for?
Because I don't know what y'all going
to
ask.
You got a dog, so you don't need to be scared. Little diggy protect you. Little diggy go protect you. This is the unrestricted hour.
Mm-hmm.
Where we open ourselves up as host to a plethora of questions.
There you go. Use his SAT words. Okay.
A plethora of questions.
Okay.
No, that's not an SAT. That's a GED word. That's not quite SAT. That's GED. But yes, we're opening ourselves up to a plethora of questions.
It better get
from any and everybody. So you can call in, especially if you got one from Mo. If you know her personally and you really know her business real tight and you really want to just spill the tea about something she did a long time ago and it's funny, it might not be funny, it could be serious. As long as the statute of limitations has passed, call in at 240-455-5934.
What's that number again?
240-455-5934. 5934.
All right, all right, all right.
All you almost was Dwayne baby mamas can call in too at 240-555-5934.
If Dwayne only gave you half of the money for that joint and he disappeared after call in right now. He don't got the other half still, but you know, you might be able to reconcile something. You can
call in and tell me how you feel, baby.
Tell me how you feel.
240-455. No, did I say 455? Oh, did I say the right number?
You said it. You're doing it right.
4-5-5-5-9-3-4. I didn't even look at the wall.
I know. You did good.
I almost had it.
You did good. Damn. You did good.
Lynette, call in for Smokey if you want to tell us how. Never mind. Ladies, if Smokey gave y'all that bush.
Look, Smokey don't got that bush, okay?
He gave that bush.
Smokey stands up in it, okay? I stands up in it. Like the statue in that mug.
Hit us up and let us know. 240-455-5934.
Have you been down, Mo? Have you been down to the Martin Luther King Memorial?
Is this a trick question?
I'm asking.
Is this
you. Like a. you see how the statue be standing up straight? That's how I stand up straight.
Wait, because I'm like, hold up.
She's like,
Maybe.
I got some questions for y'all.
Ladies first.
Start with Dwayne.
Oh. Well, you know, we can start off easy, you know.
What time is it?
It's after 9 o'clock, so the kids is in bed.
So up to 9:30, we're going to do...
The first lady at most church is asleep, so she's not listening.
She was asleep at 6. She came in the house with...
I'm getting ready to take a nap. I'm going to try to listen.
Child,
to
you know I go to bed at 6 o'clock. I just got in 5:45.
Cletus, bring me that Martin Luther King fan. It's hot in here. So, we got some questions for each other.
Okay, that's what's up.
So, who's going to start? You wrote up your... See, he always got good questions.
He do.
Because he really can, like, pick your background because he really know both of
do
us.
Do I? So. I go then. Let's see.
Like, first
are
question.
We doing restricted or unrestricted?
Dwayne, was that
you can do
your
whatever.
Facebook site? No. The one that you erased the comment.
What? Uh oh. She wanna get Ben knocking.
She went into her file. She was like, hold on, let me look at my file.
No.
All right, so
I can start off with an easy question for you.
Go.
This is an easy question. This is a
let me turn the music down so people can hear us.
This is a restricted question. Right
Let's go.
Dwayne Davis, could you see yourself marrying out of race?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
What race?
Would I prefer to marry?
Yeah.
Not prefer. I just said any race.
I mean,
no, I want to know.
Step it up.
That part of the question is her only.
Step it up.
Little Spanish chick.
You already said it for me.
Little Spanish chick with the little.
No. Nah, you can't get no Spanish chick. You play too many games. You get cut.
Trust me. I've had a few.
What? Oh, okay.
I had a few.
What race haven't you had?
Chinese girl.
Probably Pakistani or something like that. Probably Pakistani. I had a
you had a white chick too?
Chinese girl, yeah. That, you can put her on.
You ever had a white
chick? Yeah, no.
She was mixed black and white?
No, she thinks she was black. So I don't consider her white.
That's a funny joke. You only get it wasn't a real white girl. That's different.
She's like a wigger girl?
Yes.
Oh,
so
okay.
I really didn't.
Like she grew up in the hood, like, you know. Yeah. Okay, so she knew how to do cornrows and stuff like that.
She know how to cook collard greens.
Yeah, if she cook collard greens and you don't need no seasoning in it, you like she knew what she was doing. So you would? Okay. Yeah. I didn't think so, because you know you kind of militant, you know what I'm saying?
Are
so,
you messing up over there?
You know, he like you be wearing dashiki and stuff, you be like, I survive, you know what I'm saying?
I'm
like,
black, y'all.
And I'm black, y'all,
and I'm black and I'm black and I'm black, y'all.
See, I thought he was gonna give a different answer. So okay, that's good. Mo, can I give you okay, these are unrestricted, so I can't ask you this.
What?
Let me ask him.
I'm saving this one. I'm saving because.
Are you ready?
You said 9:30 or
yes,
restricted, right?
Oh boy, it can be whatever.
Just warm her up,
Mo. Have you tried peeing while standing?
Yes.
Okay. Woo! That's part of the question. Where were you standing? Because,
it's like stand squatting joint.
Did you have
not over the toilet. That's what you mean?
Standing. Like regular. When I say squat, I said standing.
Yeah, like stand like this.
Over the toilet?
Not over. I said not over the toilet.
Okay.
Okay.
You said where was I?
Check that off. Because I was like, did she have the little thing they got on Facebook where the girls put it on and look like they can stand and pee like a dude? Because I'd be mad as shit if I seen you doing that and you look over your shoulder. I'm like, what the fuck?
Hey, look, we all pull up on Saturday run.
She got out. She holding both hands down. We're like, what the fuck are you holding?
Oh, Mo, you good. That's good. You participate.
Hercules.
Shut up.
Yes.
That's gonna come up again too. Woo. Okay. Mo, remember you told me you was peeing while you standing up,
waiting for that bus, and you had that transfer in your hand.
With your tennis skirt
with
on.
With your tennis skirt and your book bag so your mother would see.
Tennis skirt and your K-Swiss.
And your slouch socks.
Go ahead, who's next?
Mo. A.K.A. Off the Cuff Shorty.
I know. You ain't see all my questions written down right?
Yeah, you got a long list.
This is just a regular question.
Okay.
For both or just?
No, it's not. Are we restricted or unrestricted? It don't matter.
It don't matter.
Dwayne.
Davis.
D-Nice 202. Have you ever got with on the same night a woman at a party that you were promoting?
Yes.
Yes, Your Honor. I am guilty on several counts.
You are so hot. Young, you're like a OT.
What does GTD stand for?
You're like a wrong, dog. You're an OT, huh?
Oh, damn.
You're original thought.
Well, let's get an unrestricted question for Dwayne right now. You ready?
That was the one?
Okay. That was unrestricted.
Damn.
That was unrestricted. Mm-hmm.
Oh, you want me to come to your event, huh? So you can do it to me? Is that what you... I saw your co-host said,
that's why your flyer glossy. You think I'm going to give up because you got a glossy flyer? Like...
Because you paid the extra $10.
He be like, oh, no, he got the little cars now, girl. He got money.
Oh, you got real tickets for your event?
What you mean you want to talk to me in the back room? Mm-mm. I saw the show. I'm trying to do it.
So.
Whatever. Not them little ratchets.
Wow! Cut it out. Whoa. They did nothing to you.
Right. Nah. Innocent ratchets do not need to be harmed in this.
Look here. Exactly. Look here.
So, be nice.
Yes, sir. Yes. I feel like this is.
You ready?
A roasted Dwayne.
This is an intervention.
Right.
Stop being a flat.
What's the most women you slept with in a 24-hour period? The most women you've slept with in a 24-hour period.
In 2016. No.
Now you got to give them back
one,
to his back.
One.
Good answer. Good answer. Good answer.
No, he was talking about because I said 2016.
No, I'm going to be honest.
In a 24-hour period.
That's it, you know.
What happened?
You know, back in your basketball days, back when you was, you know what I'm saying?
It probably was about four to five.
Yeah, you are fucking tired.
My day started out early.
He said, you gotta get him like the army. He said, I get more tail than most dudes did all day. Like, before 6:15.
I'm about to fry your ass.
I'm about to flush your ass.
Yeah, you about to get it.
Mo? That was funny, yes.
Are you next or you? Because I got one for you.
Go ahead. Oh, Lord.
It is.
If. if your friend got in your car.
My friend?
Yeah, like a friend.
Oh, okay.
If a friend got in your car and it smelled like tuna, would you tell her right then or would you let it slide and not tell her?
I'm not letting it slide. I'm not. I can't.
So what would you say
not.
To her? How would you say it?
Say it. So I'm your friend. I just got in
if
your car.
If it's just me and her.
Girl, I'm ready. We about to go to Fridays and everything. I'm about to get in your car. I shut the door.
Go. Come on, go.
Mermaid fragrance.
I'm like, young.
Bad part, she would say something like that too first.
Right.
Ooh. No bullshit. Hey, young, for real. Yeah, like, girl, no, I would ask first, like, be nice, like, have you?
I'm your girlfriend. Hold on, I'm your good. Hold on, I'm your good girlfriend right here. All right.
Yo, what you been eating?
Mo, what you mean? I just had a piece of toast in there. You know I'm trying. The skinny tea and toast. That's all I have. What you mean, Mo?
No, I be like, young, for real. You got a little older.
Older? What you mean? Like my underarms ain't right?
No, like your coochie not right.
My coochie.
Right, but my friends don't. They not like that. So not be like that. No, I'm not saying that. I'm not saying that.
Girl, you got your car. I'll meet you there.
Look, no bullshit. You know me too well.
I think I got a transfer in my glove compartment. No bull. Take my smart trip.
No bull. Like, seriously. And I would offer her, if she didn't want to go back inside and wash, I always carry Fem wipes. Remember that, ladies. Fem wipes, they, I mean,
she
yeah.
She's going to have to dig up around there.
She better get it digging.
She got to stir it up, boy. Like,
Hold it and try to get it. Okay.
All right.
I got a little graphic on that one.
I just want to know
you,
that. Like.
Why you squat, though, too?
Don't y'all
you
squat?
You got to get in there, don't you?
Right. Don't y'all squat? Okay.
You tell me.
Smoke, you ready?
I think so.
Okay, I'm on my R. Kelly shit today.
Oh, God.
Have you ever peed while sitting down and not take a shit?
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Have I ever what?
Peed sitting down while not taking a shit.
Only because I thought I had to take a shit and it didn't come, so I peed first.
Boy, then you sat down to piss.
Not on purpose. Like, you know, I thought I was going to have to shit, but it didn't come and I ended up peeing. So, yes, I had to say, without a lie.
Sure.
I've done that before.
Let me check that down. R. Kelly segment done.
Oh, whoa. What you over there? What you checking your she list? Checking it twice? Look, she tried to come for me. She like, I ain't like that one. She like, you try to say my friend smell like a mermaid.
Nope.
She was fishy on the bottom.
Than that. It's like.
I'm not laughing. I'm not laughing at that.
Oh, all right.
You know she listened, huh? Come on, let's get. I'm going to ask some general questions now.
Wait,
y'all be asking here. All right. This for both of y'all.
Oh, shit.
Okay.
Pressure's on.
Who's your least favorite host?
That's easy. That's
young.
Got to ask it truthfully. Come on.
I dislike both of y'all the same. For
nah, brother.
Mine would be you.
Thank you. Come on.
I'm just saying. It's
come
toast.
On, Smoke.
Why are you going to beat around the bush?
I really
exactly.
I really,
just
I really,
say
I really
that it's Dwayne. You fucks with me. It has to be Dwayne.
Okay, Dwayne for two.
Nah, because he's going to up my rent. Nah.
Hey, Smokey.
I don't want him up my rent.
Now,
75. I don't want to
I'm sorry, 76.
Now, you are with me, D. You got the last job
so
for me that
Mo.
Time.
So is Mo.
So is Mo what?
It's 1-1. He don't like you. Okay, so I got another one.
Because she stabbed me with that sharp-ass nail earlier. look how sharp this nail is, John. Look at this joint. This joint vicious. Like, this joint.
Who did your nails? You want to plug them real quick so you can get discount
next time? Wolverine? That's what fucking X-Men did. That's what did.
Oh, God.
So.
Yeah, it's hot in here.
It is. It's getting hotter because of these questions.
Come on, man.
All right.
Y'all ain't got no questions?
Oh, another
one? Smokey.
All right, here we go. I know what you're about to ask me. Yes, I did.
I already know that.
Oh,
okay. I already know.
Oh, okay.
So I was told.
Oh.
We know.
Oh, okay.
Me and Dwayne already know that.
I don't know.
Smokey.
Mm-hmm.
If
it was a fifth, we all be drunk. That's what some old niggas say. Nigga, if it was
I
a fifth.
Say, that's some old head shit. Go ahead, ask this, man. We only got a little bit of time.
So.
Mm-hmm.
No, I don't want
to
ask.
Okay. Yes.
Let me ask.
No, I can't.
Okay.
I can't.
All right. So, this is a general question for both of y'all.
Girl, you try. What you trying to do? You trying to ruin me. She like. she was like, if I had two people's phone numbers.
Let me no. Know. So, what's your retarded question?
Okay. Do you still text or call your ex?
You about to get somebody.
Why?
Yeah, you are so hot.
You can call and text somebody, how you doing, how the family doing.
You don't
really I saw Jamal at the game the other day.
Yeah.
You can do that.
I seen your mother at the bus stop.
Right. Man. I ain't like, get that bitch around.
I act like I ain't see her. I kept my hair straight. You know what I'm saying?
Come on, man. Answer the question. Let's go. I got to check this off.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you for being honest.
That's good.
Lord Jamal at the bus stop.
Come on. You so
right. Mo, are you ready?
Come on. You got to answer the question.
Oh. What was the question?
Do you still text or call your ex?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
All of them.
Thank you, sir.
Except maybe one.
The one you still owe money to. Come on, man. Let's go.
Oh, you ready? Okay. I got one for you.
Go.
Oh, no. Is this for Mo? Let me see. Oh, it's for Mo. Mo, when's the last time you faked the orgasm?
It would have to have been earlier this year.
Okay.
Because I just wanted it to be over.
Like what month?
What month and what time?
It wasn't during the WB months, that's for sure.
Okay.
But, yeah.
Okay.
I just wanted it to be over, so.
So, you like, did you make a noise when you faked it, or you just like, or you just played dead horse? You was like, and just like, you know.
No, I did. I went full throttle. Like, I was,
You was like, oh my God. You're
like that?
Yes. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Fuck yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Right there.
So that you gave him all that.
Come on, Mo, where your questions at? Let's go.
Dwayne.
I was
Thomas.
There you go.
Oh,
good.
Shit. Put my government up.
There you go. Smokey.
Yes.
Have you ever had sex with any of your castmates?
No. I try to make it a thing to not sleep with anybody that I work with because
you in anything you ever done, like your plays and movies and stuff like that?
Nope. I never slept with any castmates.
That's awesome.
That's good, brother.
Dwayne.
There we go. That's what I was waiting for right there.
Davis. And you. Same question.
I have. Next.
Who?
I'm not gonna say.
It's like, no, I'm playing. I'm gonna say.
How many times?
I'm not gonna say who's.
How many times? That's what I want to know. Cause I can figure it out in my mind if you say how many times.
I'm about to call Roosevelt.
Now you know he messed up everything.
No boo.
That's why I ain't got no production now.
I didn't fire him. He fired.
Would you ask me what's the same question? No, I answered the first question. That's it. I'm not gonna criminate myself anymore.
I said how many. He said it. I amended it. I just said how many.
How many
times did you do that?
With one person?
No.
No. How many castmates?
How many castmates?
Over
time. I answered the question.
Damn. Is that many? All right, let's move on.
Yeah, you're a thot.
Why? Because I just said.
No, because you're a fucking thot.
Thank you.
I mean, there ain't nothing wrong.
At least I know.
That's Scottie Pippen over there. That's my man.
That was part of my question. What was one thing? Never mind.
Go ahead.
Okay. This is a general question. What is something that people think you would never do, but you have?
Never do.
Like, oh, I can't picture Mo doing that.
Oh, like, oh,
but you did it.
I can't picture Mo cooking crack. Like, oh no, you should see her wrist game. She vicious. Like, give her a Pyrex. See what she do with it. Like, nah.
You need to think about it.
I do.
Go ahead, Smokey.
Things that they probably I don't know. People probably think I do anything.
Yeah.
Probably but go to jail. I've been to jail before. That's about it. Everybody don't know that. You been to jail too?
Yeah, she told us that.
Oh, yeah, yeah. That time she bust the windows out of somebody's car.
No, I did not.
You did a drive-by down Glen Arm?
Trying to fight people.
You was fighting outside the go-go. Nah, we from Glen Arm. Nah. You like doing just how y'all doing.
All right.
It was for a couple hours.
Promise for 6 months. Go ahead.
All right, it's kind of personal.
The season changed when I was in jail.
What are you most self-conscious about?
That's what I do, man.
That's
a hard one for me. Because, you know, when you're a black dude and you grew up in the hood, the thing that you're most self-conscious about, it becomes who you are. So, like, if you're black and you're like, I'm too black, they'd be like, oh, what's up, black? You know what I'm saying? Hey, that'd be your name for life. Like, you know, like,
what's yours?
I don't really have, like, maybe I wish I was a little taller or something.
Okay.
Really?
I hung around all tall people. Like, everybody I hung out with back in the day was like 6'3". They were like, where that little short loudmouth dude y'all be with? We want to fight him. So, I don't know. Maybe that.
Because
I'm tall when I lay down.
What am I subconscious
on a twin bed.
on a race car bed.
Okay, I'm gonna be totally vulnerable right now.
Yes. Okay? Yes.
You got an Audi, don't do that.
No, hell no. Ew, that's ugly. No, and I'm gonna say this, and I bet you any girl watching this be like, me too. What I am self-conscious about, and my sister will actually like back me up on this.
Your real sister or your sister?
No, my real sister.
I don't give a if they're real sisters.
Every woman, and I don't care what size you are, there's this little chunk down here of fat.
The pooch.
Yes.
Yeah,
that makes me so that's myself.
Okay. A lot of women.
All right.
It don't matter how small you are.
It don't matter if you work out and everything. It just gets a little smaller. I play with my friends when I go to sleep. I mean, you know.
How you do it?
I mean, some women, like, they don't dress appropriately for her.
So it
looks nasty.
Like,
I show. Pick it up. Mo is human. That's good.
But cool. I mean, I don't have to pick mine up. It's not like that.
She's only human.
You're human. That's good, though.
That's a good one.
Okay.
All right. So,
I got a question for y'all.
Oh, Lord.
Okay.
Would you pull a plug on a parent or a child if you had no choice? Would you pull a plug?
Oof. Somebody else might have to do it. I don't think I could.
I guess it depends on what's the circumstance.
That's it. That's all. The machine's keeping them alive.
I could sign a paper, but I don't think I could pull the plug.
I wouldn't personally do. I mean,
I would pull the plug.
Yeah.
Okay. I would
pull the plug.
Yeah.
I'd pull the plug because I wouldn't want to suffer and I wouldn't want to see my kids suffer. So that's it. Okay, we got time for one more question.
What is it?
Oh, y'all had one? Let me. I like to hear mine? Here you go.
You do one, then you do one.
Come on, man. Hurry up.
Me?
There you go.
Is it for you or?
Why do it smell like weed in here?
Oh, I'm sorry.
My bad. I should have left it there. I swear I should have left it in the car. But my pocket's sweating. It's hot in here.
Yes.
So it's, you might be getting a little smack. You know what I'm saying? So.
I'm going to set the tone. Come on, man.
If you could only have sex in one position for the rest of your life, what position would it be?
Doggy style.
You.
I would say doggy.
Oh!
Better not be for me.
It better not be WB.
It's like, you don't like doggy. I know. Like, you wasn't saying that last
you
night.
You said something about my legs behind my head.
You was trying to do the pretzel. Excuse me. I think we got a caller right here, right?
Oh, we did. All
right. Hopefully this worked because we paid our rent. Unrestricted Radio.
Hey, family.
Hey, what's going on? Who's this?
Who's this?
This is your North Carolina connection. Don't bet it off North Carolina. That was not my call. I had nothing with North Carolina last night. That was not my fault.
We was curious. They said there was one vote missing in North Carolina why Hillary ain't win. And we heard you wrote in Mo instead of voting for Hillary. So.
Hey, let me tell y'all. When I tell you there was some crooked stuff going on, because I work on election polls, and again, when I tell you that there was stuff going on last night, we were 2 weeks ago actually, I thought, but there was stuff all across the world. It was a hot mess. They were burning churches and stuff.
What's your question?
Girl,
you done went on and on.
Ow, that was shit. Lynette, I hate to tell you, the game is about us.
Lynette answered every question we asked. She was like, first of all,
you're supposed to call and ask us a question, Lynette.
Well, Dwayne has to make a decision right now. And he's going to have to pull the plug on you right now. Call us back, Lynette. We love you, baby. No, we just joking. We just joking.
Do you have a
Moses
question?
Moses gave you a lifeline.
Do you have a question for us, Lynette, before we go to break? Did she hang up? You hung up on
her? Oh, my goodness.
Exactly. She was like, I feel it coming.
She was like, it's coming. I'm going to hang up before they hang up. I'm going to beat them before they hang up on me.
You want to get yours in before you go to break?
Okay, I'm going to set the tone real quick. Just something slight.
Okay, something slickety.
What's the grossest thing you had in your mouth?
Wow, Dwayne.
Wait a minute.
Wow. Y'all better not fuck with me in my game.
The grossest thing, Mo? Go
ahead. Come on, Mo.
Does it rhyme with false?
Tell the people. Come on, tell the people. Okay, we're going to go to break right now. I'm going to let them simmer on that, people. As you know, I got them both stumped right now.
Yeah, because I don't know what... I don't like it. This is Unrestricted Radio. Call in if you got some questions for us. Unrestricted questions. Restricted questions at 240-455-5934.
Make sure they got good questions like I do.
Yeah, because he got some damn good questions. Really look, she took her headphones off early. That's how you know the question was good. Call in, y'all. Unrestricted Radio. We'll be right back.
Right back in the building, we ride, we hustle, okay.
remix.
Yeah, you see, we did some DJ stuff on that joint real quick. You was like, ho. Like
DJ Wayne.
There we go. We back, y'all. Unrestricted Radio, because Wednesdays are
unrestricted.
That's right.
Man, I need some people to call in for me, man. Y'all born.
Yeah.
We born.
All the,
yeah, y'all born.
Phone number is 240-455-5934.
Y'all so born, we had to get somebody else to come up here.
I know. And he got some good questions. I know he got some good questions, because I could tell. And look, I was about to say, I got a good question for Mo. Now that I think about it.
Hey. First of all, hold up.
But let's
go back to the question I asked before the break.
Oh, my gosh.
The nastiest thing.
What is the grossest thing you had in your mouth?
Pumpkin pie.
A protein pack.
All right.
Wait, hold on. I got a question.
What?
Was it from GNC or was this a home protein pack?
It was a natural blend.
Okay, I just wanted to make sure. I just wanted to make sure with that natural sunshine.
Natural blend.
Okay.
So who do we have? Hold on, who do we have here?
I about to say, what would you like to introduce your guest?
Yes.
My guest is like my best friend, Monty the
That's
Great.
My best friend. That's my best friend.
That's my best friend.
If you paid attention, we had Monty on the show before.
Yes.
He did a good job, so we had to have him back again.
And he also got music.
He closes out our show.
He closes out our show. We play a song.
Yeah.
It's called Good Night, right?
Yeah.
Dizzle pretend, so it just works. Yeah. I forgot to say that's a percent. We haven't paid the full rent. We haven't paid the full rent. So
they're
those
like,
are
you only
pretend.
Get three.
Yeah. So you might have to take one ear off so you can hear it perfectly, because that's just how.
They take
EBT. Yeah, we also take out of state post dated checks too. So just in case.
I can't even.
Don't worry about it.
As long as they can hear me, it's good.
Yeah, they can hear you. They can hear you.
I bet.
So.
All good is all good.
Oh, I don't need that.
What you got? What you got for Mo? You got something up your sleeve? You got something
that's
tricky?
That's my dog, though. That's my manager, though, man. I can't really.
Oh, so now you manage
it. Crank her
out like that, Paul. Whoa, I was about to say, crank her out?
Hey, yo.
I'm trying.
Oh man, that's like Biggie and Puffy. Huh? I mean, Puffy and Biggie, huh? You ain't gonna throw Puffy under the bus. Puffy ain't gonna throw Biggie under the bus.
Yeah.
Oh, ask me a question. Then I'm
gonna
see what she has. Ask me a question.
Okay. What's the wildest place you ever had sex?
The Dave and Buster's in Whitefoot.
Inside the Dave and Buster's?
Oh yeah, that's doable.
The ladies' bathroom.
Yeah,
oh okay, that's hot though.
Damn, that's gangster.
Right. It was the handicap stall too, so I had plenty of room.
Yeah, and the little bar. You go flex on the little bar and everything in that joint. Dang, I gotta try that, ladies. If you're ready to go in the handicap bathroom with Smoke Dog, let me know.
240.
Yeah. I limp right up in that joint. They won't even know nothing.
Right.
Damn.
And you?
Oh, in the snow outside. On my Eddie Bauer coat.
Young. Seriously?
Yeah. I swear.
This last blizzard?
Oh, no. This was like 1997. The blizzard of 97 or 96. I was outside. I laid my little... I was pressed.
Trying to be romantic.
Well, actually, she said she wanted to do it in the snow. So I was like, I'm not touching the snow. So I laid my EB down.
Oh, you know what I'm saying?
And it was in the apartment complex. There was a lot of snow. And he was like off like out in the side or in the little grassy area that was covered in snow.
The grassy knoll.
But I'll never do that again.
Mr. Dan, rather. Not.
We already said it, the club event. So, I mean,
I don't know. I'm asking you.
I've done it on Fridays. I've done it in.
Which one? Greenbelt?
Greenbelt. I've done it at RFK Stadium. I've done it at King's Dominion Park.
Damn, you got a bucket list of spots.
He's not like, say he's an OT.
He was like, I got head on the shockwave and everything.
What? Come on in, girl. Let's go. I'm adventurous.
That's funny.
What about you, Mo?
Well, the wild wave at a... Six Flags, and the little thing next to it.
Hold on, what a wave! You was in the wave pool?
Yeah.
Was the waves on?
Yeah.
Oh, you must.
But the little thing next to the wave pool, when you get in, it's like the little lazy river thing.
Oh yeah. How was you cutting in there? Oh, you was like,
but you gotta be in the mood.
Yeah,
you know, you in the little donut.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah,
and
yeah.
And then they just take you around the little thing. So we just went around a couple times.
Yeah. Damn. So all
right, I got
people. That bird is like. Yeah, that's why I don't get in it.
All right, I got a little general question. Oh, no, we're keeping it nasty.
Nah, go ahead.
Go ahead with your generals.
Nah, I ain't going on no general.
General,
I got somebody going to play the game with me.
Yeah.
I'm asking okay, anything. For the group, let's go. Which do you prefer, aggressive or passive sex partner?
Aggressive. Passive. Choke me, pull my hair.
Okay, now.
Yes.
No hair you got?
Don't do it.
Passive with aggressive tendencies.
Passive or aggressive?
Like I want to. No, I only want to aggressive at the beginning. Like, yeah, grab my dick. You know what I'm saying? But then don't be scratching me all up all hard and slapping me and pinching my nipple. Aggressive. Right. Passive.
Okay.
If I have to choose one.
So I'm gonna say passive, but submissive.
Nah, passive or aggressive?
Aggressive, but no teeth though.
Yes. Hey, she got
good answer.
Teeth, man.
That's a good answer,
okay,
right there.
Okay. All right.
Well, you ain't answer your own question.
Mine's aggressive. I don't like passive. I don't like.
He probably be trying to be all smoothie, like go ahead, take control,
that
baby.
Turn it off. I just lay there like.
She slapped that nigga in the face.
Yeah. Like it's here. What are you doing?
So it ain't gonna suck yourself. Right. I mean, damn. Like.
All right, so we go another one. Let me check that one off. I got some good ones, man.
You do. Hold up, I got one for you.
Uh oh.
Have you ever cheated? Well, no, not cheated. Have you ever had sex with one of your exes, like best friends? Or somebody that was like in her core group?
Yes.
Oh, I have. Thottish. Oh, Thottie Pippin ass.
Thottie Pippin? Me? Yes, 100%.
Oh. Welcome to the club.
It was a referral program, actually.
Exactly. That's how it normally works.
Actually, I heard about you.
That's like, how it works.
Oh, did you?
Okay.
Yeah. Heard they call you Sweet Dick Willie. he's been on every page of that book, so. But he's not there anymore, ladies. Just so you know, he's a changed man.
Yeah, he's changed.
Everyone up on his on here is a changed man.
That's right.
Just so you know.
That's right. Changed woman too, right, Mo?
Indeed.
Yes.
Oh.
Hey, listen, check this out. I got one question.
Mm-hmm.
Mo. Well, not Mo. I'm not a singular out for the group. Have you ever cheated, but in your own bed with you and your spouse?
Yes.
Stay. You guys leave.
Ooh, that's a tough one.
What's that? After so many years or something?
Oh, the statute of limitations?
Yeah, I'm under that. So.
Yeah, you gotta be a savage. Statute of limitations. Yeah, yes, you do have to be a savage.
I was a savage before, I'll admit. I'll answer my own question. Yes, yeah. I did it. I was a youngin', but, you know.
I ain't gonna lie. I've done it, but I wasn't a youngin'.
Last year, shit.
I've never.
At the end of this show, we're going to have.
I have.
For Dwayne. Yes,
I have never. Yes.
Yeah.
Why, I've never.
Nah, I just thought that was like completely disrespectful.
I got one for everybody.
Okay, go.
Have you ever smashed siblings, like sisters?
Guilty.
Got him, man.
See, I didn't talk about steps.
That counts too. That counts too.
Come on, man. We're not talking about incest.
No, like
I don't
siblings.
Care if
like,
they're real
you
sisters.
Hit the girl
like,
then her sister.
Oh, y'all. Okay.
I know. I was there.
Maybe
too
I'm
first.
A man
with it. I was like, that's nasty.
That's what y'all thought. Like, oh, no, I knew what you were talking
about. No, at first, like, I had to get
through. Yeah. That's. Why not?
But have you? Have you ever done it?
Absolutely.
Oh, okay. Have you ever?
Yes.
No.
You hit brothers?
Wow.
We're brothers.
We're brothers.
We're happy and we're singing and we're smashing.
Only one time. One time.
Okay. But I can't lie. I hit two sisters before.
I had cousins. I mean, they're not. That's not cousins. Siblings. But cousins.
Like a given, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, is it a given? Anything is a freaking given for you.
I mean, cousins are like a given. That's not like.
Yeah, because, you know.
But I mean, first cousins like they. But sometimes, like, they, my cousins are like my sisters.
Right, but what I'm saying, people more. They are more hesitant to deal with siblings versus cousins. Oh, God. Because most of the time, I don't like that bitch anyway. Oh, yeah, come here, girl.
Yeah,
Yeah. Right, you like, you know what? She never deserves you anyway, boo. Like, I know, no. I know, right? She wouldn't like you. She only used one hand.
So real quick, what time of the day do you enjoy sex the most? Morning, mm-hmm. afternoon, night. One of the three.
No, all.
One of the three.
Morning.
Okay, morning, man. Here, Smokey.
Right after work.
Would that be afternoon or night, Smokey?
Afternoon.
Which one do you work? Okay, afternoon.
Afternoon. Okay. I don't work the night shift.
Might work the night shift. Being difficult.
I'm not. Well, the yeah.
She like what kind of sex?
The wake up joint.
Morning.
Yeah.
Okay.
I got one. Y'all want it?
I be having to pee in the morning.
Hey, listen. Check this out. Have you ever dry snitched on a homie or a friend to their significant other that they were cheating?
Never.
Oh, never.
I don't.
G code. Live by. Die by.
Even if I don't fuck with you no more.
Dry snitch.
Nah, even if I don't fuck with you no more, I don't do it.
Yeah, that's what I mean.
Yeah.
Like,
even if I don't fuck with you no more, I still won't.
Nah.
Mm-mm.
No, never.
Because I hate when people do that to me.
What? That's bad karma.
I hate when people do that to me.
No.
Yeah. Wait a minute.
I think so.
We need to take this to court?
I just didn't hear her answer.
Oh, okay.
I said no twice.
Okay, because I wanted to make sure you didn't dry snitch. Because we'll hold the trial right here, right now. You are.
This a hell of a jury.
Hey,
too.
Hey, look, and here we do speedy trial. You know, you get your speedy trial. You are granted that.
Yes, indeed.
Man, are you thinking about it again?
No.
Oh, that's your final answer.
No, twice. Yes.
Okay. I was just making sure. Oh, that was a good one.
That was good.
That was a real good one.
That was very good.
Has anybody slept with any of their friends' mamas or fathers?
No. I'm not attracted to
somebody's
mom.
Somebody's godmother, but not no mother.
Hey, yeah, you are a savage.
He was like,
actually, she was the second person I had sex with.
He was like, seriously. He was like, you know, your godmother was looking fat at Christmas.
She was the second person I ever had sex with. She was 36 somebody's and I was 16. Yeah.
But he was a tall 16, so. He,
no matter. She's 36. Like, nigga.
Next question.
No, but
that's a good one.
Y'all is probably like the same.
Nah, mine's just late.
What time?
Mine's 15.
That was your first.
I'm late.
Yeah,
mine's
15.
What you?
13.
I was 7.
Yeah, he said
I
that.
I knew, but
he
you know that. What? I got a story though.
My babysitter.
Yeah.
I was 17.
It started with a massage.
Actual intercourse.
I was in college. Actually, it was a week before my 18th birthday.
No, I tried to do the oogie coogie in kindergarten though.
Teacher caught you, didn't he?
She ain't even catch us though,
yo. Nasty.
It was like a boy girl bathroom. We was in line, right? Never told the story.
Exclusive.
So two boys, yeah, this right here might not be able to ever become anything besides work. So no, check this out. It's two girls, two boys. I'm gonna make it snappy. So me and this girl go to back. Me and the dude go to bathroom, right? You know what I'm saying? But the girl in front of us, I tell her, stay in the joint. You know what I mean? So she stay in the joint. So the teacher at the table, she across the room. My two girls come out. I'm like, yeah. Everybody like, yeah. So me and my man go in the joint, right? He's scared as a bug. Right? I'm like, man, I'm going to go ahead and do something, right? So me and the joint stand up. We five, y'all. We stand up in front of each other, right?
Yeah.
We like stand up in front of we got our pants around our ankles, right? We like this. Guess what she say? You supposed to pee in it. That's what I did, you know? Peed all over.
Oh, man.
Pulled my joints up and walked out, so I was a savage at five.
Hey. That was
a little young R. Kelly Jr.
He was in that joint. I don't see nothing wrong.
I feel horrible for telling that story on the internet right now. Mama, I'm sorry.
Hey.
I apologize.
Mama, I love you.
She remembers. Yeah, she absolutely positively remembers.
Oh,
we are still friends.
My gosh, that's hilarious.
That's hilarious. That's even better that you still know the person. What's wrong with
DC public schools and allow some crap like
that? How do you hold up? But how do you explain to someone? You call you like there was an accident in the bathroom. Just bring an extra pair of clothes for your child. Yeah, we'll tell you the story when you get here.
She got in trouble because her parents thought she peed on herself.
Yeah, I'm about to say, they probably thought she peed on herself. Yeah.
She was like,
what you got on your cards? You got something on your cards, savage.
God might have not died on the cross for sins like that.
So you're going to be all right. I'm going to pray for you. God know your heart.
This question is for Mo. Does size matter that much?
It does, actually.
Okay. And if so,
and I'm going to tell you why.
I mean, I don't want to know why.
No.
I was just asking.
Because remember your question about if you only have that position for
the rest of your life.
You can't be small and try to hump me from the back. You just can't.
Why?
I don't like the falling out. Like, oh, you need to be in.
You don't like that? Like, oh, sorry.
No, hold on, it's let me not try. An oh, sorry.
Let me try again. Hold on. Wait a minute.
Yeah, you need to be
so what
in.
Size is too small, though, really, though?
If you fall out. If I can't.
Let's get
I don't
right.
know.
Like,
I can't really.
Measurements,
I'm not a good.
If this was a penis.
Let's get measurements.
So, like, no. That's too much girth right there.
You sure?
That is too much. Nobody knows. Hey, young. This is nobody.
I'm sorry for putting this back.
All right, sorry. I got one for Smokey. Since you're an actor,
absolutely.
Uh-oh.
Would you kiss a man in the mouth for $10,000?
$10,000? No. How long?
You're an actor.
But how long?
You're an actor.
How long
is your project?
How long is there project? Tongue involved?
Would you kiss a man in the mouth for $10,000?
Smoke, I'll do it for
probably not 10,000. I probably need like 25 right now.
No,
10 G. Cause Will Smith, you know what I'm saying? That was the catalyst to his career. He kissed that man in Six Degrees of Separation, and his career took off. I mean, like,
but I bet you didn't get paid all that money that you asked for though, either.
25?
He wasn't an actor. That was his.
That was like his like second thing, or yeah, one of his first really things. Yeah,
he wasn't. So as a starting actor, you wouldn't do it. Okay, cool.
Oh yeah, because he was in a bed with him and everything.
I request your answer. I don't know.
Would you? Because you're an actor.
$10,000,
like cash on the spot.
But first, he get to stroke your beard and then kiss you.
No.
He was like, no.
Honestly. As a starting actor, that can probably hurt you. Because then people, he would look good in that gay scene.
Yeah, they're like, they try to typecast you. Like, so we got this new gay movie. So. It's called All the Men's. We want you to star.
But I'm not going to lie. That $10 will help on child support.
Like,
I might take one for the kids.
Brand new movie starring Dwayne Davis called Let's Hear It for the Boys.
Like, I might take one for the kids.
Do. Like, oh, shit.
Let's see. Why did you break up with your last girlfriend?
Because he was starting
crazy as fuck.
She was crazy?
Yeah, she was extremely crazy, man.
Okay.
Yeah.
Like how crazy? Like the type that like hurt you while you sleep, or like she just this looking at you caught her crawling around the bed trying to check your phone while you were asleep?
Yeah, like you wake up and she's sitting up looking at you.
Oh yeah,
that's with crazy. Super glue in her hand.
Oh, man.
No. That was crazy.
Super glue in her
hand. Yeah.
No, and that leaves
your eyelids closed. You can't wake up.
To my next question. That leads me to my next question. What is the craziest thing that you've ever done to your mate? Like sexually? Like I don't not believe no not sexually
oh.
Just like oh my gosh she got me out my character and I did this like and you like I do not believe this why and I will go first.
Are you really gonna go first?
I will go first.
Please don't, because I don't know if I can take it.
You already know.
I know, that's what I said. I don't know if I can take it.
I'm not gonna lie, and the people that's watching this, some of y'all already know,
especially the person.
This was in my 20s, shout out Renzo. But I found out that he could possibly have been cheating, so he went to sleep and I super glued his dick to his thigh.
No. Young. Young.
I was like 20.
I would have never.
Possibly. Huh? So you never got facts.
You never got facts
that he did.
You did that off of possible?
No, like, but he did cheat though.
After that, I would have cheated too. After that, I would have cheated.
No, I mean, he cheated, but I wasn't so much sure. But I was like, this by me is cheating.
What was the healing time on something like that?
Well, we had to go to the hospital.
You did that off assumption.
That's
That's crazy.
That was a good one.
No, that ain't no good one. You done gave other women ideas.
Right? You're like, they don't make that type
of thing. I would never do that now. Like, that was 20 years ago.
You'll wake up
like, got gorilla glue now, bro.
Where's that?
Damn, Renzo, I feel sorry,
man. I hope everything healed right, cause you know what I'm saying. Whole,
I hope you still got the color to it,
right? You know what
no,
I'm saying.
No, it's not. Got no, thank you.
This color right
shit.
Exactly.
He's like, he got some. Nah,
exactly.
I got that thing Michael Jackson got, but a lie go. That's on my joint. You know what I'm that's why.
And guess what? He'd think about that every time he want to cheat.
Oh my goodness.
But what did you do? With around here. No, I want to start with you.
And you want me to tell you? I'll tell you.
Okay.
One time I took this girl out, right? Me and my man, like, it was like a. She was like a high rolling chick. She only messed with ballers. So it was like. And she was bad, so I got with her, took her to dinner. Dinner came out to like 300. Like, she hit my pockets. Went back to her spot, got in the joint, and she got the faking. I was like, I'm not about to get no cheeks. And she jive like tried to curry me. So I was like, oh, I got something for her. So I went in her bathroom and I gave her a topsider. And that's when you take the top of somebody's toilet off and you shit in the top of the toilet and then put the top back on. And then every time they flush their toilet, doodle water fill up in the joint. And they can't figure out why.
Wait, because what is this now?
It's called a topsider.
That's that Mo County white boy shit.
It's called a topsider.
That's that Mo County white boy.
It's when you take off the top of somebody's toilet and you take a shit in the top of the toilet.
Oh, right. In the
and then
back.
Put the top back on. So every time they go to flush their toilet, my yeah,
the top part.
Yeah. See, so every time they flush their toilet, it fill up with doo-doo water because that's where the fresh water be at.
That's disgusting.
So the bathroom be cranking and you can't figure out why. You're like, what the fuck? What's my toilet broke? And I left and I was like, and my man laughed at me like the whole ride home.
You're like a stinky savage.
And that was the worst thing I ever did. So I should have caught.
Young, that is disgusting.
Yeah, that's off the
hook. Hold on, I know you ain't talking dick grabber, like dick glue. You're right.
Hey, I was trying to make a point.
We are equal, okay?
Yeah, y'all might be in the same group. Man.
That man went to the hospital.
Left a joint at 7-Eleven. Like, dropped off and, like, she got the faking or whatever. she
was, like, miles away from home.
I'm like, yo, what you want on the 7-Eleven? I'm going to go in, boo.
So and then you rolled out?
Went around the aisle and got my car rolled out. You like that. You
know, and she's like nowhere near her house.
Is a mug. Like, I'm talking about like
wow. So you're savage too.
She was like, she was at the slurry machine still pumping the drink.
Before Uber and all that shit. So you know what I mean? Like how you call your family member and say like I'm stranded at Potomac Mills?
Right, and they live in Laurel. Damn.
Like hurry up.
They live in Northwest.
Like, this Slurpee almost gone. You need to hurry up and get out.
What you do?
Mine would be. Actually, I had several.
No, let's go with the most recent.
I don't really have the most recent, but let's say one time I had an event. My ex came in and she first started some stuff at home. Then she came to my event.
She brought it to the event?
And wanted to start some more stuff there in front of my family and friends.
Well, this sounds familiar. Like I was there.
I lost all composure. Professionalism.
This the choke out joint?
Yes.
I was there. I was there.
She swung on me. In front of everybody because she wanted to prove a point and get the attention.
And you went Joe Jackson.
And I just flew across.
Who put the string on my guitar?
And just put my hands around her.
Oh, my.
And it took my father, my sister, friends, family to get me off of her.
Yeah, that was like some Love and Hip Hop stuff.
But that was like at a breaking point of I've taken so much. Like, if you do Wednesday and Thursday of this at an event and then the rest of the days of the week, you'll get your breaking point too.
And y'all live together, right?
Yeah.
So what's your stuff inside or outside when you came home?
7 days a week. Which is crazy.
Okay.
It was inside.
Lord have mercy.
Yeah, I was there.
She was like, yeah, I was there. I remember.
I do. Yeah. I was there.
It was wild because it was just like, come in, just start something.
Was he looking like the skinny hawk when he did? He was like, oh.
Yeah, it was like, it wasn't him, though.
that's how much it
It was the hawk. It was
but
the hawk.
But know what I've been going through. And it's like, I can't do it. Oh, you blah, 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 blah. Poked me in my face. All right, man, go ahead. Cut it out. See you at home.
And then she was like, oh, you know what? Yeah. And she came with that.
And then you old sucker ass. Yeah. Okay, all right. I'll talk to you when I get home. I mean, it was one of them type of issues. And it's like.
Out of body experience.
Right, exactly. That's what it was. I was.
Well, thank God for your father because with your nails, you would have cut her artery and that woman would have died out there, okay? What I want to tell you is. People, we've all been through some things here on the Unrestricted Radio Show. Even our guest here, he's been through some things as well. But don't judge us for those things. One day in life, we might want to run for office. We might want to do some other things in life. Right. So please don't hold this against us. There you go. You know, we're just radio hosts. We're singers, actors, family men, deaconess at the church, and a couple other things.
On the usher board,
the one that pass out the fans. What is it that you do at your church? You do all that. So we want you to know that if you have some things in your life, don't be ashamed of it. Feel free to talk about it, okay? And we'll be back here next week, unrestricted. And we got what we got? A tax person coming in.
Yep.
And they're going.
I need him.
Yeah, we.
This week. Oh, she deep, brother. She's
going to.
She is deep.
She's going to come in. She's going to talk about taxes. She's going to talk about why you should or should not claim your neighbor's child on your taxes.
And I owe like $27,000. Can she help me?
How much?
When I say she can help you.
True.
She probably can.
You might need to get Rick Ross' attorney because he owed like $4.6 million, and that's a lot of money. You know what I'm saying?
Come back next week.
Nah, square business. I'm going to be right here sitting in the couch.
Yeah, I'm about to say come through for real. Cause
with my taxes, though.
We got somebody for that. So also, everybody who was up worried about that election, don't let that stress you. Go to work. Live your regular life. And you know what?
Amen.
No,
amen.
Regardless if Donald Trump was the president or was Hillary Clinton, they're not going to teach your child how to read. They're not going to teach your child how to be responsible. And they're not going to teach your child manners. That is all up to you. So you have to do that. You have to explain to your child what's going on anyway. And it's up to us. So don't worry about who the higher power is. Yeah, things might get tough. But we're going to get through it because we always do.
Let's give a shout out to A1W Graphics for tonight.
Yes.
Wonderful flyer. Let's give a shout out to our only and one caller.
Yes, Lynette. We love you, Lynette.
Yeah. Love you, Lynette.
Even though we got to hang up on you sometimes because you get a little long winded, and if you was a.
Yeah, keep it moving, boo.
Yeah.
We got to give a shout out to.
that's our number one fan, so. We love her.
I like Lynette.
We got to give a shout out to Sunny, our producer. Sunny in the City.
Yes, Sunny in the City.
Started early on this night.
Yeah, she got something.
She got
something. You know what I'm saying? I'm Thursday. You know what I'm saying?
She like, yeah, I gotta take my glasses off for my backpack on.
Yeah,
my Uber here.
So
she driving.
Mo, I guess.
Yeah, shout out to Monty the Great, Lamar
Jamal. I appreciate y'all for having me, man. Like it's an honor and a pleasure, man. You guys are doing a great job. I love what you guys are doing up here. I appreciate you guys.
Appreciate it, bro. Thanks a lot. We're gonna have to have you next time Mo's out of town when we had the barbershop talk.
Right, you know what I'm saying? Cause
that sound like my type of
show. Oh yeah, the barbershop's
on. Actually, you know what we should do? We should actually just steal him as a friend from her, like she does to you with your friends. Hey, and just compliment.
I am not giving you his phone number.
Right. I won't. Like, she's like, where y'all at?
And Mo get you killed. You know what? She had this fingernail polish. I want to know. She got it from. Oh, yeah, Mo.
Yeah.
Blah, 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 blah.
Because you know I be hitting you. Like, what you doing? Oh, we had the Bob. We in Lamont.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Where are y'all at?
We're Lamont.
You hanging with that little nigga?
Yeah. Like, we about to go to business.
You hanging with that little nigga?
Nah, but you know I shade you. Oh, he was there already?
Yeah.
Like, y'all really not hanging together.
Yeah, that's how
he probably was there and you came and sat down at the bar. No. Okay, great.
You downplay me.
But this is Unrestricted Radio, y'all. We'll be back next Wednesday because Wednesdays are
Unrestricted.
Hey, live life and love yourself and love everyone else. We'll be back next week. Oh, and this song is actually by
Lamont Jamal,
like you heard him say on the track.
Yeah.
We'll see y'all.
Hey, young.
Hello. Yeah, baby, I miss you.
Yeah, I know.
Well, I don't know what to do. What am I supposed to do?
Yeah. I don't see no levels on that joint going up when I talk. They probably ain't hear nothing I said.
I'll holler back in the morning, love, yeah.
Good night.
Yeah.
Good night.
Yeah.
Good night.
Oh, yeah.
I'll holler back.
Let's go like this.
Baby, turn the lights. Although nothing comforts you and to hold you tight. heart is yearning for me. We're miles apart, and though this cannot be, allow our love and dedication to be a bridge between us. And yes, it is a must that you know that I love you, baby. Close your eyes and fall in love with me again.
And shake your hips. It's barbecue and mildew mist. Now take your pick, cause we could cruise the strip in a spacious whip. Or would you rather call out sick? We could take a trip. I know you want them shoes from Milan, Louis Vuitton. This ain't game of karma. I'm truly a don, about to make a power move and let you be the pawn. Sexing you up and down till like 2 in the morn. It's on, premier boo. Get a little closer, relax. We ain't through, take a sip of your mimosa. Fours on the Rovers, Lexus with the chauffeurs. Trips out in Texas, stretches with the sofas. Photos on posters, mine Manolo loafers. Keep a focus with